when you assumed this job, after that short career in private practice and that career in that other U.S. attorney's office on the other side, called the Eastern District in New York, right. It was a really defining moment both for you and for Brooklyn, the first African American district attorney in the history of Brooklyn.
Yes.
And an incredibly diverse community. Tell us about the challenges of, well, you know, assuming that historic position and managing a very diverse community with lots of different expectations of law enforcement and policing.
Well, Brooklyn is, I think, one of the greatest places in the world to live. It is truly diverse, but I think even if it was not as diverse as it is, I now run the largest district attorney's office in the city and the third largest DA's office in the country. I have nearly 1,200 employees and over 500 prosecutors. We do 100,000 cases a year. And I go to work every day with the determination to do what is right. My main duty is to do justice. And that means to protect public safety, but it also means to improve our criminal justice system because it is broken in many ways. I believe that it discriminates against the poor of all races. Money often makes a difference in it. And I think that is wrong. And so I'm determined to keep the people of Brooklyn safe, but also to show that we will have one standard of justice in Brooklyn that will apply to all, no matter how much money you have or don't have, where you come from, where you live. And I think that my job is to work very closely with the police. We have common interest, and that is to protect public safety, but we don't have identical interest. I also have the duty to do justice, and I believe that those who come into the criminal justice system should belong in the criminal justice system.
One of the many things, we're gonna run through some of them that you have done, brought something very innovative, new changes to the Brooklyn DA's office. Let's talk a little bit about the conviction review unit and how you see it as part of your overall mission, if you would.
Well, what we have in the country is we have a crisis where men and women have been wrongfully convicted for murders and other crimes that they did not commit. Now, everyone who says that they've been wrongfully convicted obviously is not speaking the gospel.
Right.
But there are some people, as we sit here today, who are in prison for crimes they didn't commit. So, when I was running for DA some years ago, there was a big issue in Brooklyn regarding wrongful convictions. I said if I was successful and had the honor to serve as Brooklyn DA, I would get to the bottom of those cases. So I created a real conviction review unit. We've looked at about 50 of the cases so far, and we're standing by the convictions in the majority of those cases. There's no reason to disturb those convictions. But in 17 cases, we have concluded that men were wrongfully convicted right there in Brooklyn, and many of them sentenced to long prison terms for murders and other crimes that they did not commit. And so I believe in my heart that it is the job of the DA to correct such miscarriages of justice and to free men from prison who do not belong in prison. Because these wrongful convictions not only destroy the lives of those who are wrongfully convicted, but their families, and they undermine the integrity of our criminal justice system.
Let's talk about your Begin Again program, because it is novel, it is successful from all accounts, and it is helping to change communities. Why don't you tell people about it?
Begin Again essentially is a program to help people who have outstanding warrants in the city. There are over 1 million open warrants in New York City for people who committed low-level nonviolent offenses, like riding their bikes on the sidewalk, walking their dogs without a leash, littering. What happens is when they commit quality of life offenses like that, they're given a ticket by the police and they're given a return date. In Brooklyn, you're given a return date about 4 months later, and you have to travel all the way over to Manhattan to 346 Broadway to have your ticket adjudicated. And if you don't show up, for any reason. Bench warrant, just like that. And so I've created this program in Brooklyn where I go into the community, I bring the court system to the community. I bring my prosecutors, state Supreme Court judges, legal aid attorneys, court officers, and we hold court. We've done it 3 times so far. We pick churches, and I open it up for anyone in New York City. There's no residency requirement. You don't have to live in Brooklyn. You come to this Begin Again program, and we vacate your warrant and deal with your summons, just like that. I called it Begin Again because I want people to move on, begin again and move on with their lives. So far, thousands of people have come out to the events and got relief.
That's great. Another major and very successful program, you know, deals with the problem of too many guns on our streets, Brooklyn,
yes,
and everywhere else in New York City. Tell us about that.
Gun violence is a problem all over the country, not just here in New York City. It's important to me to get to the source of these guns. And it's very important for people to realize that 90% of the guns that are found at crime scenes in New York come from states down south. They come from outside the state. So we need to get to the source of these guns. And we have done 3 long-term investigations with the NYPD, the greatest police department in the world. I have a different approach. I believe in going after the gun smugglers who overwhelm our strict gun laws like we have in New York State. Same thing in Chicago. In Chicago, in the first 10 days of 2016, there were 120 people shot. You may say, oh, that's Chicago. It's all connected. Illinois has some of the strictest gun laws in the country, but those gun laws are overwhelmed by the neighboring state of Indiana. So you got these young guys driving over to Indiana, bringing these guns in and killing people and killing themselves. It's not about the Second Amendment. People have a right to lawfully possess guns. But what about criminals? What about these guys who are smuggling these guns on these planes?
Yeah. So you and Mayor de Blasio have, I would say, resurrected something that was tried before, fast track.
Yes.
It's a way of getting people who are arrested with guns into the system and to do it efficiently and the rest. It's a perfect segue to that effort. And tell us how it's working, because it was tried once before, different name perhaps, and didn't work out so well.
Essentially, we have a gun court in Brooklyn now to fast-track gun cases. It was tried before, it was only one judge. Now we have a number of judges who are dedicated to these gun cases, because when we catch, often as a young guy with a gun, it shouldn't take a year for that case to be resolved. Well, that guy continues to walk up and down the streets and put us in jeopardy. We need to get this case resolved quickly. So now we're trying to fast track these gun cases. It started in Brooklyn, and the plan is to have it in all parts of the city.
Thank you very, very, very much. Great of you to come. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.